Well, welcome to Beer Goggles Reviews and doing the old GBBH, the Sainsbury's Great British Beer Hunt. Every year they do, not far away from the GBBF, kind of similar sort of names, Great British Beer Festival and Hunt. I don't know if there's kind of a copyright on that, but it's close, isn't it? You know. Anyway, Great British Beer Hunt. And what they do is that they kind of have a little bit of a competition. I think, I'm going to have to check up on this, but I'm pretty sure that along the way, us guys, you know, all us kind of people sitting out there buying it and drinking it, get to have a little vote and stuff on it, you know, and judge it for ourselves. Hopefully not just have one and then go, yes, that's the one. Tried a lot. I think there's about 20. I've got 20 anyway. But I think there's 20 in the range. So try them out. Try them along with me in that, you know, and you tell me what you think. And also tell the brewers and tell, because a lot of these are new beers, you know, a lot of them. Not all of them. There's other ones in there. I mean, I recognise sitting there looking at a Wayfarer there. And I'm pretty sure I've had that before. But I can't be certain, you know, I can't be certain of who I am in this day and age. I'm like, all the brain damage, who am I? Sitting there calling the toaster a hot thingy. It's near the hot thingy. Right, sorry, I'm sorry. Right, I think first one we're going to have is a right, you're going to have to excuse pronunciation. Goninor brew that. Goninor brew that. It's only a little 3.8er, right? So it's kind of low ABV wise. I'm not sure if Williams Brothers do. It's Williams Brothers, by the way. I'm not sure if Williams Brothers do another one that's low ABV. I'm trying to figure, here he is. I really don't. But we're going to see what it's like. So far, I have never had a Williams Brothers beer that I've not enjoyed. Everything they do, I think one of theirs, I just thought was kind of quite nice, like that, you know, and not nice, right, but quite nice. And all the rest have been, yeah, right, you know. So I'm going to see how this one is. As I say, 3.8, so it's kind of, you know, almost breakfast kind of stuff, isn't it? I think it is. I mean, in Scotland. Scotch whiskey's breakfast in Scotland, isn't it? So I'm sorry. I don't mean that. I'm not. Listen, it's only a laugh. Right. Here is the lovely Williams Brothers Crown. Beautiful, beautiful stuff. And I'm going to pour this in my... Oh. Is that got... I've got to have a look at that. Sorry, I've gone off remit here. I've got a big... Is that a scratch? I've got a big scratch down my glass, look. That's Dear Girls, I think that is. Anyway, I'm going to pour that in there. I'm not sure how much bottle conditioning we're talking here. So I'm going to... Nope, can't see any at all. So just pour it in. Pour as we go, be gentle with it, and pour the head in as you get towards where you want to be. I want to stop about there, so there you go, there's the head. Right, you can have 2 fingers, 3 fingers, 20 fingers. You know, I go on about it all the time. It don't say about the quality of the beer. You can get a massive, big, fat, fluffy head on Bombardiers, and you can get a fluffy big head on Fosters and any sort of crap beer. It don't really, you know. I mean, yeah, I've had beers as flat as a witch's tit and stuff. My very favourite beer is an extra imperial double extra stout. And this is, you know, the head on it goes down like that. But it's, you know, it's quality. But there you go. So, sniff. Lovely, beautiful, nice, little, little weird little notes in here, little peppery, little kind of pears, kumquats. We've got pears, little hints of bergamot, and little gentle floral hints. Let's just twist that again. Little peachy notes and kind of apricot notes. All really nice. It kind of tastes as if you, smells as if you've got a bit of like something like a Citra or, I don't know, Simcoe or something like that. And you've got a bit of Goldings and kind of nice little British chaps in there as well. It just says on here, hops, hops and more hops on a bed of hot mashed barley to balance the bite and aroma of these hops. And then ingredients, water, malted barley, wheat, hops and yeast contains gluten. And then there's all sorts of other languages. I don't know, probably, what is that? Danish or something? Possibly. Yeah, look, I'll show you it so you'll be able to tell me. Look, stuff down the bottom there, you got that? Yeah, all right, business, come on. Yeah, not one I recognise. Right, let's see what it tastes like. Cheers, everyone. Chin chin, slanchy. Oh. No wonder it's 3.8. That sucks you into the glass. I went to like that, and he's and then he ended up with my head inside the glass. You know, when you see with a dog with their head inside it, trying to get it out. I'm sorry, but no, that is lovely. That really is lovely. A nice citrusy kind of citrusy four note there, coming in kind of nice and sweet. Nice and a bit sugary, a bit sweet, a bit lovely. All kind of juicy fruit and everything. And then, big sort of dry Chardonnay finish coming in. Really lovely dry finish on the end. That's beautiful. And just coming in, but not harsh, but just dry. Almost, you know, almost like the experimental beta hop. There have been experimented for ages with, and no one seems to pick up on that, but it's a lovely hop. It's kind of a bit like that dry, really lovely. I like that. Let's get a little bit more down, see what I'm going to tell you, and then biddly boo. That's lovely, it really is lovely. Little lemony bits, little grapefruity bits, pink grapefruity bits, with a little sprinkling of sugar over it. Like breakfast juice, you know, with orange and grapefruit. You get little tangerine notes. You're getting all sorts of really lovely little fruity notes in there. And yet, it's still those earthy notes to just balance it up and keep it kind of tethered and keep it nice. I do find sometimes you get some fruity beers and they go, way, woo! And they're kind of like, everything's hanging out and falling out. And it's kind of, you know, it's like a well-stacked woman, you know. It's not quite so attractive when it's just out all over the place. When it's all pulled in and pushed and, you know what I mean. And that's what those, I'm sorry. That's what those hops do. They kind of push it and pull it and hold it and get everything tight and off you go then. I'm sorry. But I'm going to pour the last bit in, see if there is any bottle conditioning. And let's have a look. Nope. Clear as anything. No smear or anything. So, lovely stuff. Everything doesn't have to be bottle conditioned to be a good beer. Don't have to be a real ale to be a good beer, you know. So, it's the boys out there got a new thing, campaign for RGB, really good beer, I believe it is. And I think it's a good idea because it kind of opens it up. I mean, years ago that had the real out against the McLagers because, you know, the McLagers were abusing it all. But what's happened is that real owls sometimes, supposed real owls, they're abusing it as well. So, you know, he brought up a beer for all sorts of colouring crap in it. Yeah, I know, kind of the same thing, but so broken record. That is lovely. Get that one down. That's a nice one to kind of go a bit easy on, you know, when you're having a little bit of a break. 3.8. Okay, I'll have one then. You know, and all the others are drinking 6, wee, 7, wee. You go 3.8, give it a chance to sort of sink in, and then you get on the 6s a bit later, you know, when your body's had a bit of a break, and then back on the 3s again, wee. Do it clever, you know. See you in the next one. Dunny, got it all brewed up. So, yeah, don't ask me what that's all about. I'll tell you how old Sofa King drunk. Our Danny McFadden. Danny McFadden, the paddy. I'm sorry. Is there anyone I've not upset out there? just leave your comments below. I can't help it. I don't mean nothing. Take care. I'll see you in the next one. Don't be late, because I will start without you. Honestly, I will. I'll start without you. You'll be going, what's he on about? Cheers. Why am I pointing? I need you. Cheers. Take care. Billy Boo. Bye. We'll be right back.